How you doing, everybody? It's Randy Richard in the shop. I'm finally having some time in the shop for Christmas vacation, and I'm going to try to get this Hemingway Kits compact rotary broach constructed. So these are the drawings, and this is the written explanation of how to make the parts and go through it. There's a nice little picture of the completed parts, actually. The drawings are very nice. They're made in a nice paper. It's like dirt oil resistant, I don't know, something. It's really nice. Large drawings. Nice color drawings. Good explanation. Showing metric and inch dimensions. Nice little part list there of what materials you need to use and what's come with the kit. The bearings, the 1-inch material, 7/8 material. I'm not sure what they mean by FCMS. I'm not sure, but it's like cold rolled steel. Is what the material looks like. As you can see here, this is just a scrap piece, but that's what it is. So we're going to just follow the instructions and go along to see how good everything is. And the first part we're going to build is the locking on another color picture. Is the locking ring. There it is. Locking ring. So the locking ring is this part right here, part number 7. And that goes in right here. Right here to hold in your spindle and the bearings. So you got the radial bearing right here, a small one, and then this is the thrust bearing, and then another radial bearing, and this is the locking ring that holds all this together and holds the spindle inside the body. So we're going to make the locking ring first, and there's a detail drawing right here. Here we go. This is the detailed drawing of the locking ring, identified by part number 7 over here. Now the drawings are nice and big, and that's about, I don't know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 or 5 times larger the size of the real part. Just so you know. Here you go. Now I've already completed it, but I'm going to show you how to make it. There's the completed part compared to the drawing. This came out very nice. It's threaded on the OD here. There we go. So let's go over the lathe and get started on making the locking ring. So this is a 7/8 stock. This is about 3 inches long. We're going to turn down only about 1/2 inch so we to make our locking nut or ring. Stick it out there, plenty of room to work on. I'm going to rough drill the center to 25/64, and then we'll bore it to the final dimension.
about half an inch. Take a measurement on the stock so we know what it is. And we're gonna take it down to 787. So on 873. We'll take a rough cut and then a finish cut. And for the finish cut. .783. We're shooting for 787. Close enough, right? So I drilled it to 2564. 402 is the number. We're going to get a rough measurement. Then we're going to use a 402 gauge pin to gauge our hole. We're at 0.394. We're just going to go 402. It's only another 8 thousandths total. So we just barely have to take a whisker off. We're just going to touch off and I'm using a dial indicator on the ways to gauge my depth of boring so I don't hit the bottom. That's close. Right at 400. We're just gonna kind of do a spring pass. Well, I'm just under, like 401.8, just, we're just barely under. It's got to have clearance for 10 millimeter, they said, so. If I put a tiny chamfer on the edge there, I'll just sand it. So 402 pin doesn't want to fit, but I'm sure I can hammer it in. But 401 goes in there, just goes in. So I think we'll just leave it 401. Now we do need to do a counter bore on the face here. 16 millimeters in diameter and only half a millimeter deep, so that's 20 thousandths deep. And 16 millimeters in diameter, so that's 0.630 roughly. So I'm going to go in with a boring tool, with this little boring bar, in 20 thousandths, lock my carriage, and then I'm just going to draw it back out until I get my diameter. All right, there's my 20. We'll lock it. Now I need to go about 115 thousandths on the dial. So we'll come out and touch. And it's going to slowly come out 115 thousandths. This is so that this only makes contact with the outer race of the bearing. You can see our counter bore there in the face of this. That came out just right. 630 thousandths cross there and 20 thousandths deep. I'm going to go in here about a quarter of an inch. I only have to go in, 6 or 7 millimeters. The part thickness is only going to be 4 millimeters thick. So I'm going to go in a little extra and 6 or 7, 8 millimeters. And I'm going to put a groove that's 145 thousandths deep. Just using the parting tool. That's my depth of thread. But I meant to say only 15 thousandths or 14 and a half thousandths deep. So we have our groove in there for our thread relief. I'm just going to do my compound's not even set at 29 and a half, just set zero square with the work, 60 degree tool. We're only talking 15 thousand deep threads. So we're just going to do a scratch pass and maybe two passes, 52 threads per inch. So my question is, I have to do a 52 thread per inch thread. How many of you have a gauge that has 52 TPI thread gauge? I had to search high and low, but I had one. It's made by Craftsman. Screw pitch gauge made in England. And it has 52 on it. All of my other gauges didn't have that. So we'll be able to check our thread. All right, I have my lathe set up for 52, it says. We're gonna find out if it does it. Oh yeah, that looks pretty good. I have to get the magnifiers on. All right, thread's good. Now we're going to take it out of the lathe. We're not going to part it off yet. We're taking it out of the lathe, and we need to drill two face holes in the front there. And we'll do those in the middle. Little face counter bore threads. I don't know if you can tell, but they came out really nice. 52 threads an inch. That might be the strangest thread I've ever cut. And probably one of the finest. I think I put the clamp in the mill vise.
And my vise, yes, it's still set over at 30 degrees for my making dovetail cutters. But this is round, so it really doesn't matter how it's clamped in. I used the edge finder, found the center. Now we're going to come over to 75. And that's half of 14 millimeters. And that's right there, out there on the edge, which looks okay. And then we're going to come over here to the other side and do the same thing. And at least 7 millimeters, they say, in depth. Now we'll go 275 to the other side. Then over the lathe, and we're going to part it off. All right, I flushed this up at the end. I moved over 6 millimeters, about 230 thousandths, and we're going to part the piece off. Now that will be the finished size of it. They say it's 4 millimeters, but we need room to part off and face it and things like that. I'm using my Seco tool here. This thing works really well, actually. A little bit warm, but there we go, parted off, faced with the holes. Now when we, I guess, fit the other piece, so that's when we face this off. Thanks for watching, you guys. Part one, almost done. And then we'll go on to the next step of the project.